Greetings from Tromaville. I'm Lloyd Kaufman, president of Troma Entertainment and creator of the Toxic Avenger.
Let this be a lesson to you, hot ass.
Whose musical played in Hawaii at the Manolo Theater. But what I really like is Friday Night Frights. Friday Night Frights is, it's like the Manolo Theater and Toxic Avenger musical, but way, 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 way up there. You got to see Friday Night Frights.
Don't forget your beard.
Oh, my love. Oh, I love this.
You
best
look,
costume
You look
ever.
Like a luchador.
Oh, my God. He looks like South Park.
Yeah. Huh. That is awesome. You look like my friend Matt, who wrestles in Lucha Underground. What's up, everybody? It's Friday night, so you know what that means. It's Friday night fight time. Yay! And it's Friday the 13th.
Oh, it's so scary.
Of course, it's me, Killer Cal, a.k.a. Jason Voorhees. We got Tony Midnight, a.k.a.
Hi.
Scary
Hi.
Guy.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay. You know Jason?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm Mason.
Mason. That's Mason, my cousin Mason Voorhees.
I couldn't afford the hockey man.
And we got the lovely Allie B as...
I am Naked Blood Tempura Hand.
Tempura Hand.
Where's your tempura hand?
It's right here. It's my tempura hand.
Tempura hand.
Oh, so good.
I can't get my mouth. And we got, of course, Al Jawa in the house.
You know what and he is? He's a Safeway biker.
Tony's 13th facts on Friday the 13th.
I'm a messenger of God. You're doomed if you stay here. This place is cursed. Cursed. It's got a death curse.
Who are you? What do you want?
God sent me. Get out of here, man. I got to warn you. You're doomed if you stay. Go. Go.
There you go. Don't touch me.
At number one.
Number one.
Sean Cunningham, director,
mm-hmm.
creator of Friday the 13th, the first one,
mm-hmm.
got the idea for the movie from watching John Carpenter's Halloween.
Yep. Really?
What?
Leave me alone!
He's gonna get you!
He's gonna get you! He's gonna get you!
He's gonna get you!
He's gonna get you!
He's gonna get you!
The boogeyman is coming!
Leave me alone!
He doesn't believe us. Don't you know what happens on Halloween?
Yeah,
No, Jamie. Watch out. Watch out, Jamie. You know he's around. You know. Oh, there he is. I told you he's right around the corner. Jamie, look behind you. Look behind you. Turn around. Behind you.
I'll turn.
Behind you. Behind you, Jamie. Jamie, turn around. Oh, God.
You mean he needed inspiration?
He did.
What?
So basically, the first Friday the 13th has that archetype. Yeah, of
Michael Myers.
All you see is like the hand, or you see the legs, you know, walking towards you and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Do you have like a greatest hits that you sing to when you do it?
Sometimes. Like the music from Friday the 13th Part 8.
That's how you get into the groove.
He created the fist bump. You know how the Guidos do the fist bump? He created that. That's what happened.
I like it.
My cousin Mason did it, and some Guido that escaped was like, oh, I like that.
Yeah, Jersey Shore.
Get out of here!
Get out of here!
Standing in one corner, 4'9", 2 inches with the poof, Snooki popping for Lucy. Standing in the other corner at 322 pounds, the Staten Island dump.
Bring it on! Bring it on!
Next thing you know it, round two!
Bring it on,
bro!
It's only two girls!
Don't get snook!
I'm still here! Hey, I'm so pretty! Hey! I'm so pretty, bitch!
And it's like beating up a baby, Snooki. Like, you know what I mean? Like, she's so tiny. Like, her arms are like Tyrannosaurus Rex arms. Like, you know what I mean? She can't even get a full reach.
Jersey Shore, forget about it.
Forget it.
A little too small there, pal.
Number two. During filming of Friday the 13th Part 4.
Ooh.
Kimberly Beck, who plays Trish. You know Trish?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, Trish.
Yeah. Experienced strange occurrences. Ooh. Including a man watching her while she ran in the park.
I'm telling you.
And strange phone calls at all hours.
Son of a bitch. I'm gonna give you something to this boy.
Dun, dun, dun.
This all stopped when production was over. Number three. The original title of Friday the 13th, 1980, the first one, according to screenwriter Victor Miller, was Long Night at Camp Blood.
Mm. Oh, it wasn't Tuesday, February 3rd?
You go to Camp Blood, ain't you?
God damn it, Ralph, get out of here. Go on, get. Leave people alone.
You'll never come back again.
Oh, shut up, Ralph.
It's got a death curse.
He's a real prophet of doom, ain't he? Come on, climb up, miss.
You're a dirty old man. You can't keep your hands to yourself.
That's illegal.
What you're doing is illegal.
Can we, like, switch it up?
Saturday. Right? Saturday the 14th. We're going to change it. And we like the 13th.
The 13th, we're a little busy.
Yeah, it's a spoof, huh?
We need to do that. We need to make one. Like Monday the 2nd.
April 420.
420, baby.
Can you imagine that, though? If they had stuck with this title, we would have the series Long Night at Camp Blood.
Oh, I can't wait to go watch Long Night at Camp Blood.
Yay!
Boring. No.
Long Night at Camp Blood Part 3.
No. They even have 3D. It like a...
In 3D?
They'll have it like a short. They'll call it Long Night.
Long Night at Camp Blood. Jason Takes Manhattan.
I know, right? Number four. Jason has killed 167 total people throughout the Friday the 13th series.
He should be in jail. Whoa.
Change your mind or what, Melissa?
Talk about serial killing.
That's a serial killer.
167.
Wow, 167 so far.
At number five, Camp Crystal Lake is actually Camp Nobibosco.
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 It's the operational Boy Scouts camp.
Ah.
That the cast and crew was granted access to after the campers left for the summer in 1979.
Nice.
That was a great year, you know.
It's still in use today. It's still in use today.
Oh, so that answers your question. It's still open.
Questions.
Like, when we have a budget, we need to travel to some of these locations from these movies and do like a full show from these places.
Oh, we definitely have to go.
Wouldn't
to,
that be so cool?
Pittsburgh.
Oh yeah,
that would be so cool.
The mall is still
George
open.
George Romero. Yeah, Monroeville. Yeah.
Friday Night Frights. Yeah.
If you're fashion-minded, watch out. Big-time shopping is finally here. Monroeville Mall.
On tour.
On tour.
We go?
We go, bro.
Yeah.
Dover, Colorado. Dover, right? It's Dover, right?
Yeah,
it's
Dover.
Dover, Colorado. You been to Dover?
Nope.
He's been to Dover.
Have you been to Dover?
I've been to Dover.
What?
Have you been to Dover?
I've been to Dover, but I never been to Dover.
You ever been to Dover?
I'm telling you, this why we need to do this.
Yeah, we need to bend to Dover.
Bend to Dover. Okay, I'm taking this off. Hold on.
Yeah, hey, you listen. Sound so muffled.
I'm the only one that can cosplay legitimately today. Oh, look at you. You're so scary.
All right, there we go. That's better.
That's better.
Ooh. Yeah.
Okay, we can hear you more.
All right, that's good.
All right.
All right.
All right, so number six.
Number six.
Larry Zerner was cast as Shelly in Friday the 13th 3D. Part 3.
Shelly?
3D what? When the producer spotted him handing out flyers for a horror movie. He was one of those guys, you know, the guy, come watch this horror movie.
Do you see how close we are to stardom?
Yeah, and so the producers asked him, hey, you wanna star in a horror movie yourself? You know, you wanna be the one?
He was like, yeah.
He's like, What is it?
Shelly! I need some money.
Probably some weird working title, like, you know, Birthday Bash Part 5 or something, you know?
Bikini Bash Part 5.
What about this killer named Ethan?
Yes.
Seriously, that was the working title for Part 7.
Really?
Part 7, yeah, Birthday Bash. You call it a Birthday Bash because you know what happened. It's just somebody's birthday, right?
Oh, yeah.
They're all at the cabins. And, no, get away from them. Don't touch the mask. But, yeah. So
you must ask her nicely if you can touch her mask.
He doesn't know how to do that.
No.
You remember who Shelly was, right? In Friday the 13th Part 3?
No.
Yeah.
I would have to watch it again.
He is the guy that's responsible for this.
What, the mask?
Yeah.
That'll teach you a valuable lesson. Beautiful girl like you should never go out in the dark alone.
Damn it, Shelly! Why do you do these stupid things?
I have to.
No, you don't have to.
I just want you to like me.
I do like you. But not when you act like a jerk.
Being a jerk is better than being a nothing.
I never said you were nothing.
You don't have to say it. I could tell.
You're wrong. Shelly.
Really?
The guy, the freaking Mr. Makeup, Mr. Magic. It's always, he did that effect where he's like, he has that axe in his head.
Oh, yeah. Like,
it's my bag. I'll take care of it.
Shelly, what are you doing in there? Why aren't you down at the lake with everybody else?
Oh, they said they were going skinny dipping, and I'm not skinny enough.
Shelly.
You know what? Can you just say that one more time? Because I just got a Shelly in my life, and I feel like saying that to her.
Shelly.
Trying to ruin my wedding and everything.
There's a lot of on here.
Speaking of, do you know Hugh Hefner died a couple weeks ago?
Yeah, shout out to Uncle Hef, man.
Uncle Hef.
Made man out of me.
That's so cute.
You got to turn to the side a little crookedly. A little bit more. Little bit more. Yeah, there you go. That's it, right there.
Heavy, it looks like stud. Yeah, hat on the side.
Every time they had the Halloween, the October issues, they would have like a little review of all the horror movies that are best to watch. So.
Yeah, I always read the articles.
You know what? Some old ladies came attacking me on social media this weekend when I was defending some Hugh Hefner. He said, he's so gross. And I'll say, oh. I said, listen, sweetheart. I'm trying to make you like a bunny. You're like an animal. This is,
what?
Or my daughter could go get drunk at a bar and some guy could walk up and go, girl's gone wild. Let me see your boobs.
That guy
you know what I mean?
That anymore.
How about that?
Number seven.
Number seven.
Friday the 13th Part 6, Jason Lives, is the only film in the franchise to have no nudity despite having a sex scene.
And they wore their clothes.
It's a sex scene, but they were wearing clothes, remember?
You gotta keep it up to the end of the song.
How much longer?
It's only 10 more minutes.
Like I had his shirt off, but she had that black, that long
she
black.
Had a dress on, so she was dressed, but she was ready.
The only one. Every other one had sex scenes, topless.
Right.
Yeah.
He was going through a dry spell.
Yeah, he was like, it's called Jason Lives. No nudity on this
one. They make it more eerie and creepy. Oh, he rose from the dead.
Al Jawa.
Oh my god.
He needed just a nice.
Al Jawa has no response.
I have no response at all. Man.
No.
I did not take the cupcake.
No nudity. No nudes, please.
Why would we ever make cupcakes? A movie like that?
You got cupcakes?
No nudity.
Hey, you want a beer?
Or do you want to smoke some pot?
Or we can have premarital sex.
We love premarital sex.
I want cupcakes.
We know.
Tell your girlfriend you want cupcakes.
I want cupcakes.
Oh, puppies?
You better tell Betty Crocker to get herself a cookie.
I want the cookie.
Take you back
you better
to
tell Aunt Jemima.
Aunt Jemima?
Yeah, throw down the pancakes,
oh my
girl.
Aunt Jemima.
She did the Aunt Jemima deal.
He lost. Good job, Val. He lost.
Aunt Jemima. No, it's good. Whitney, shout out to Whitney. I'm sorry, but if I see you and I go Aunt Jemima, you know why now, okay?
Number eight. Betsy Palmer, who plays Mrs. Voorhees, only took the role because she needed a new car.
Yay!
A new car!
Yay!
Oh, my Lord. So young. So pretty. Oh, what monster could have done this?
Oh, my God,
and
I want a new
car.
You get a car.
You know what? I would totally do it. If someone's like, hey, you want to be in this movie? I'll give you a car. I'm like, okay.
All right. And she killed her role, though. She killed it.
Yeah, she killed her role.
She was like, I'll do this, man. Awesome.
Thing is, when she went to the audition, her car broke down on the way back home. So she's like, I'll take the part.
I'll take it now.
She went to Ford, and they were like, no, we can't finance you. She was like, I'm in a movie now.
Oh, side fact about Friday the 13th, 1980, the original, right?
Right.
Sally Field.
Love Sally.
Tried out
love
for the role Sally of Field. Alice.
Wow.
The final girl.
Really?
Yeah, she auditioned for the role. She never got it, but.
She would have been great.
Sally Field.
She's super sketchy.
Can you imagine that?
Yes.
Wasn't this Kevin Bacon's.
First movie. He's like,
Number nine.
Number nine.
And Friday the 13th Part 2, Jason was dressed to look exactly the same as the hooded burlap sack killer from the movie The Town That Dreaded Sundown.
Oh.
The only difference is that the burlap sack he wears only has one eye hole.
This man's identity is unknown. He was believed to be between 30 and 40 years old. He wore a white hood.
Jason, mother is talking to you!
Ah.
And it's shirt is slightly different plaid design. Slightly different plaid. Hi.
Hi.
How you doing?
Hey, number 10. You want to do this on number 10? Number 10. Go ahead, say.
Oh, number 10.
Lord have mercy.
Good job. Hey, man, you're awesome. You're doing a bang-up job, dude. Hey, we're going to go to a fun factory someday, man. Play a claw machine.
Number 10.
Out of the Friday the 13th series, the series has nothing to do with the movies.
So what's on the agenda, Houdini?
I thought we'd tell a few ghost stories, maybe a few tricks. Scare them just enough to let their hair down.
Right.
Nothing to do because weird. It's completely different. They just took the name.
It's so weird. You know? I hate that.
Somehow, like, maybe produced by the same company that put a hand in the movies, but it was
it's
never...
It's like when your cousin names their kid after your kid, but their nationality don't match their kid's name.
No, it kind of reminds me of... You
it's
know,
like LaDasha, but they live in, like, Palmdale.
These are my daughters. These are my daughters, Monique and Unique.
I have a wife and two kids, and I'd like to see my twin daughters, Monique and Unique, again.
It's just right on your way out.
And he's like the whitest little like suburban guy.
It reminds me of when the mainlanders come back. Oh, this is McKenna. That's Haleakala. That's Kahului right there. That's our son, right. Kahului.
This is my little son, Robert Tussin.
Robert Tussin.
Robbie
Here's Peaches and Pumpkins.
Yeah. Tussin. We call him Tussin in the hood.
Out of the Friday the 13th TV series,
all right.
John D. LeMay is the only main cast member of the series to have appeared in a Friday the 13th film. Which one is it?
Oh.
This is a pop three.
Oh, okay. Number 8.
I wasn't going to say that. I was going to say number 3.
No?
No.
What about number 3?
No. No.
Wait.
This is after the series run.
Oh, Freddy Goes to Hell.
Freddy Goes to Hell. Huh?
I mean, Jason Goes to Hell. Sorry.
You're right.
I'm afraid.
No, you're right, Jason. Though.
He's
the main guy in that movie, remember?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. I got 8, and I always get those mixed up. I don't know why.
Well, you see, one, he dies, supposedly. Final Friday.
Yeah.
The other one, he's in New York City.
Finally, they have a Friday.
Nobody talks about the
Times Square.
Nobody talks about the recent Jason movies. Like,
Shut up.
Like Jason X. Or...
Why Jason X was dope.
Or Freddy versus Jason.
That was another dope movie. Although it wasn't, Kane Hodder wasn't in it. They got another tall guy to play.
Yeah, Jason's tenure was only from 7 to Jason X.
Yeah.
Yeah, number 10. 7 to 10. 7, 8, 9, 10.
Which is one of, like, that was the dopest Jasons ever when Kane Hodder played Jason.
Kane Hodder was awesome, dude.
He was a method actor, man. Still is, to this day, a method actor.
Method actor and originally stuntman.
Yes.
So he knows how to give performance with his body and everything. He doesn't even need words, this guy, man.
No. He's that guy that looks at you at home when you don't do the dishes right.
That's right.
Wait, you're like, what? Right.
He doesn't give this looker.
No, he don't get. He get a scary look.
Death House.
I wonder how hardcore sex is. If he's like beat you up. He's like, slammed you on
Let
the wall.
Let me stab you with my machete.
He's like, slamming your head into the wall.
Wait, wait, don't look at me. I'm going to come out in character.
You're like, ow. And he's like, I like it when you scream out.
Get in his sleeping bag.
Yeah, right? You're like,
oh. Like, this kind of hurts a new definition of getting wood.
No!
Deesh, deesh, deesh. Did you come? No!
Couple more times!
Sorry.
Number 11!
Number 11!
We're almost done here, kids!
Number 11!
And Friday the 13th Part 2.
Uh-huh.
Originally, the sex scene between Sandra and Jeff was longer and it included full frontal nudity.
That's because they were really doing it. Oh, sorry, no, guys. Back in the day, they actually did that.
No, they couldn't. They couldn't. They couldn't.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Because
he couldn't get it, like, happening?
No, because actress Martha Kolber
was on her you-know-who.
That week. Paramount Studio discovered that she was underage. So it was completely deleted from
wow.
the script.
Whoa, full frontal with a youngin, eh? But she was 17.
He totally got her on that, too. He's like, oh, yeah, come on my movie. Sure, we'll tell everybody.
That's why when you watch the scene, they're like done already, right?
Right, right, right.
And he's over her, and all you see is just midriff and head. That's it.
Ah.
Jeff, what? You ready?
For what?
Camp Blood.
We weren't supposed to go near that place.
Oh, come on. It's only a short walk. They'll never know we're gone. Jeff, I'm serious. I really want to see it. Look, when we get back to the city, we can tell everyone we were there. Oh, come on, you chicken.
Plus, that scene, too, was supposed to be more graphic because the spear through the two bodies.
Yeah, yeah.
There's supposed to be more blood that sprays out from when the spear hits the guy's back.
Oh.
Shish kebab. But, Paramount was like, I don't think this gonna work for an R rating.
Really?
Tone it down a bit.
Tone it down. Let me go in an X rating.
That would have been an X rated scene. Apparently, X rated movies yet, like extreme gore stuff, had X rated up to it.
That's crazy.
Yeah, that's X-rated. Creepy.
Well,
12.
During the filming of Friday the 13th Part 8, Jason Takes Manhattan.
Right, right.
Right? I'm gonna play the Jason Takes I love this song. Okay, during the filming of Jason Takes Manhattan,
mm-hmm.
it's, I lost it now.
Oh, y'all.
Okay, during the filming of Friday the 13th, Kane Hodder says that is one of the most fun parts of his tenure as Jason.
Going really? To New York.
Yeah. And his favorite part was the scenes they shot at Times Square.
Oh.
If he can kill him there, he can kill him anywhere.
Yeah, because he had to film that movie in, like, Idaho, in, like, a
no
small
way.
Town.
Can't do that.
And so he's, like, oh, finally going to freaking the big city.
Kane Hodder went on to say, he said that spectators were lined up and down the block watching the filming. So you had the filming, you had, so everybody on the sidewalks. That was all spectators.
Oh, for real?
Watching the filming of the movie.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
He's going through Times Square. So, he didn't want to take off the mask to destroy the illusion of Jason. Once in a while, he turned his head and look at them with that Jason stare. And the crowd would go crazy.
Nice.
Wow. He loved every second of that. That was like the
That was biggest. The highlight of his job.
Times Square scenes, which might have to be one of the most fun scenes that I've ever done as the character, because there were so many people on either side of Times Square watching the filming, because we were right in the middle on a traffic island, and I was in full costume. It was pretty amazing, because I would stand there in between takes, and I didn't want to take the mask off to destroy any illusion, whatever, just to have more fun. And I would just stand there, and people would be watching, and I'd just turn and look at them, and they'd go nuts. And it was like so amazing that I felt like, you know, one of the Beatles or something, because the response was so tremendous. And we shot there all night. Did a funny scene with the kicking of the radio and all that. So it was just a really fun night.
Got that meat slime bag.
Don't
cool, man. It's cool. It's cool, man. It's cool.
Career, oh my god, Jason in freaking Times Square.
He's like, everybody loves me.
And all he's doing with the mask is just...
People are like, oh, I love this stuff. Bob, I always wanted to say
marry me, Jason. Stab me with your machete.
Robert Englund went through the same thing when he shot Nightmare 4 because they were like at the beach, like Venice Beach or something, and they were shooting a quick scene there.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And the crowd was just going crazy. He would pop out of the trailer.
You're waving.
Hi. It's totally a thing to go follow movies in LA. I followed my aunt told me one time to follow a movie, but it was really just like a active shooter.
Oh yeah, that's.
I was like, what the heck?
What's this going on?
Yeah, but man, you can go see everything. I went to go see 90210, and the day that I went, there was a bomb threat.
Oh my god.
Man, you just bad luck for filming movies.
Lucky you didn't go to a country concert.
Nope.
Oh, Lord. Too soon.
Oh, my God.
No, especially because I know someone that was there.
Oh, no, I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. It's my friend. It's a Sonia's cousin. The lady that her son passed away.
They're safe.
She had an operation. She got shot.
She did?
Yeah. Sonia's cousin. The one that her son passed away that came on my show.
Yeah. Her cousin was one of the
hit
victims.
People.
She didn't die. She got surgery.
No, she's in the hospital.
Oh my God.
Crazy, huh?
Crazy stuff, man. Okay, so the final.
Number 13. But he can't touch. Come back again.
He's got a death curse. The final fact that I have chosen for the 13 facts, Tony's 13 facts of Friday the 13th series. Victor Miller had originally given Jason the name of Josh.
Josh Voorhees.
It's so scary, Josh. Josh, what are you guys trying to kill me for?
Josh!
It's Josh! You got blood on the carpet again, Josh!
Oh my Josh!
Can you imagine that? Corey Feldman coming down the stairs, all shaved up like that, and look like he's like old Jason.
Right?
Josh! Josh!
Are you kidding me, Josh?
Josh! Remember Josh?
Josh? He's like, Josh. I don't want to be called Josh. Call me Jason, Mom.
Here's a little fun fact.
Ooh, Al John's got a fun fact. It might not be fun, but here we go.
I hear that the final scene in the original Jason, the jumps.
Today, Junior!
Friday the 13th.
Yes, Friday the 13th. The jump scare scene.
Yeah.
I heard that was not planned in the movie as well.
No, it was like a last minute deal.
Yeah, it was a last minute
deal. Total last minute.
Yeah, they added that on.
You know, things happen last minute, you know, just like in the heat of the moment.
Yeah, I need to finish up number 13 because there's something more to it.
Oh, there's more?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So number 13
Victor Miller decided that it sounded too nice.
That is such a nice name. Josh.
Hey, Josh. Oh, everybody's in love with Josh.
Josh.
You want to go to Comic-Con there, Josh?
So he changed it to Jason after a school bully.
Oh.
I'd like to call him Joshua.
More fitting, right? What do you think?
I mean, if his name was Joshua, it sounds biblical. That'd be
You're like, listen,
cool.
I'm sick of getting bullied. I'm changing my name. I have a better, cooler name.
I'm Josh.
Nobody will bug me.
Oh, Josh.
Josh sounds nicer. I'm Josh now. Hey, nerd. My name's Josh now. I love you.
Jason!
Now that I think of it, I remember having a school bully by the name of Jason.
Really?
Wow. Would you like to mention a last name there?
No, I'm not mentioning any last
name.
Well, it's a small island. We'll just check
Fred.
Out all
Jason Ramos.
We'll just call all the Jasons on Maui and find out.
Jason Kong? Maybe? No, not Jason Kong. It was, huh? Jason, I know you're watching.
No. Jason.
Right here, Bob. Right here.
Jason.
Tavares. Tavares.
He's a big boy now.
Oh, Boogaloo Buzz. Right here. That's the guy.
We're naming all the Portuguese guys.
Pacheco. Jason Pacheco.
Bro, if I get these big guys come after
me. They're not going to come after you now.
Well, you haven't grown ever since high school. So, yeah, they're going to be big. With a beer belly all like, oh, bro, Ellen. Man, I used to pick on you.
Yeah, take this knife with you everywhere you go now. Well, just
what?
Because
I never picked on you. I pick on you now.
He picked you up once.
We pick on you now because we love you, man. Come on.
He's like, well, that's bloody.
He's going to kill us.
Don't cut it off. What? You might need it later.
No,
we're
going
to find you somebody that wants it.
Not after he bought his toys. He's never going to use it.
John Wayne Bobbitt over there.
He's still caught.
Listen, she's like this.
Dude, one.
Stuck on
that's
my
a dull blade, by the way.
Yes, Mrs. Doubtfire did well, and yes, I am going to play Lorena Bobbitt. That should be interesting. Drop it, thumb dick. Here we go. Mrs. Hellfire.
Take it easy, Lorena
that
Bobbitt.
This is the BME Pete Olympics, man.
You want to know the worst part about that is he went and Howard Stern bought him a new one, but he bought him like a super gigantic one.
And
it got to the point where Chick
work.
Didn't even want to hook up with him, that he had to have a reduction a couple years ago.
He did porn.
Yeah,
for a short period of time,
porn.
but no, he removed it now and made it small again.
With the Franken weenie.
You had a Franken weenie.
First of all,
who would
want to be in a porn?
He had it extended. He had it extended. So if you look at it, it's real flesh, and then there's the extended flesh. It's a total different color.
This is so creepy.
It's like a darker tone.
He rips it out and you're like supposed to act surprised.
And it was kind of crooked too. It's like they sewed it wrong.
You know? I think she fulfilled a lot of woman dreams though.
Oh my.
For all the women that got cheated on in the world that wanted to go and just cut that sucker off.
I like the kimono, but you got that Kanye West deal going on with underneath it.
No, I'm actually wearing the color of the girl. See, I didn't have an apron.
Oh.
I was gonna actually be there.
She's wearing a reverse apron.
Half and half. I'm Japanese. This is what
I'm
happens.
I'm Japanese and Korean.
Yeah.
So if I take this off.
Clean.
Like naked blood was just, you know, like semi-naked blood, you know? Like, okay, I'm going to cook it, but maybe I should save it for tonight with dinner. Comes around. Here, honey.
Here you go.
I'll put some... plastic wrap on it.
Save it
in the fridge.
So it's October 13th. That means we got 15
away.
More days before Maui Comic Con Volume 2.
And we have only 3 more weeks until our Halloween Miss.
Halloween Miss
is on the 23rd.
Yay.
It's the last episode
Wait,
of the month,
check.
Right?
Double check.
Double checking. When Halloween Miss will start playing a slow tune.
Ooh, Halloween Mist would probably be on
the 27th this year.
Yeah, the day before the Comic-Con.
Oh, perfect timing there.
Yeah.
It is perfect.
That is perfect.
It is going to be like our anniversary holiday. Like, we get to do so many amazing things.
I love Halloween. It really brings the family.
You're probably not going to be there because you're probably going to have to work.
You'll forget.
I'm not feeling good. I'm going on vacation that week, so.
I hope so.
And I hope you're doing it with us. Oh, I mean, having a vacation with us. Having a vacation.
This is what's going to happen. He's going to take a vacation that whole week and that weekend, right? And he's going to show up over here looking to be, hey, Bill Best, you have guests on your shows?
He likes to whore himself on all the shows.
He's not even
going to
come.
Hey, Suzanne, you want me to be on your show? I can talk about being a bully.
It's
going
to be Alan's annual.
He's not even going to dress up.
Special Olympic stuff. Yeah.
You know, I just want to say that last year you used to come here so swag, and then you just bringing it down. You took your buttons off, your vest, and everything.
Well, except for one.
Except for one.
He's the Safeway gangster.
Safeway gangster. Is that your actual name tag?
Yes.
Wow, dude.
They need a new name tag. They're like, oh, we don't care. It's still
bro, your name tag is dirty.
It only says safe.
It's just safe.
It's safe.
You're safe.
It actually got smashed in the cardboard compactor at work once.
You got smashed in a cardboard?
No, my whole apron got smashed.
How did that happen?
This is like a bad nightmare. He's leaning over the thing and it's like,
it's getting smashed. I'm going to die. Oh, it's just my name tag. All right.
Whitney!
She can hear you all the way from the land of food.
Come from the competitor store to help me. It's like Romeo and Juliet. It's like they don't know where to go.
There are Friday Night Frights, Romeo and Juliet. That's what it is. Two different families.
Where do you go for Christmas? They go to Costco.
<I'm> safe.
they shop at Costco.
Costco to meet them. It's the safe place. Costco.
Safe place. You go over there and get the lady. Betsy Crosser yelling at Paris Hilton eating my brain.
If they have a wedding, they should have like a Safeway Foodland wedding. Like, she'll dress up with her, he'll dress up with his side.
No, he should dress up as Foodland and she should dress up as Safeway.
See? Yeah.
Yep.
We'll get some Poke Bowls.
Maui Comic Con.
Maui Comic Con.
29th.
We've got
UH Maui Campus.
Yes,
so
I.
So excited.
Mark Teixeira from Marvel. Did he do DC as well?
He did some DC,
DC. Mm-hmm. And Joe Rubenstein.
Yeah, world record holder for most ink comics in the world.
Yeah, and he did the original cover for
Wolverine.
The
first
Wolverine, right?
Yeah, the one where he's holding up the neck.
Yeah.
And then we got Stan Sakai, creator of Yosagi Ojimbo.
Oh, man.
I love the shout out that Amy got us.
The original series where Usagi Yojimbo came from is Critters.
Was it?
Which is his which was his little comic book where it's Japan but with Critters.
Animals.
Was it with Gritters or Critters?
It's Critters.
Critters.
Oh, Critters.
Critters. Critters. Oh, excuse me.
Ooh. Hey, you want a beer?
Okay.
You wanna smoke some pot?
Sure.
Or we can have premarital sex.
Okay.
We also got the Hawaii Comic Book Alliance. We'll be there. We've got like Brian Revel. We got Theo Lee. We've got our own Todd Bernardi, Sam Campos.
We didn't mention that we're gonna be there.
So that's the end. That's the icing on the cake is us being there. Friday Night Frights.
You're the best for last.
That's right.
Madam Raven will be there. Episode next week where we delve back into the land of mysterious murders and mayhem.
Yeah.
Oh,
and
yeah.
And don't forget that after party after Maui Comic Con.
Oh, yeah.
There's an after party going on.
Yeah.
More
the tales, about that. Tales of the Comic Con.
Yeah.
Ooh. Okay, so shout out time?
Shout out time. We'll start with the lovely Tempura. Oh, excuse me.
That was me, sorry.
Oh, we did it at the same time. That's right. All right, we'll start with lovely Allie B.
I would like to give a shout out to public education.
Looked like you were going to fart there for a second.
You know what? I can never think of who to give a shout out to anymore other than the people that like to take my kids for free.
Yay! Hey, you want a beer?
Okay.
You want to smoke some pot?
Sure.
Or we can have premarital sex.
No, right we can't.
Right on, try on.
Get Alan. Al, you got a shout out? Special
out.
Olympics of Maui, got it.
Shout out. I'm not doing Special Olympics.
What if you just keep playing that over and over again when your girlfriend's sleeping? Like on low by her ear.
Oh, you should try that. It might work.
Messages. She wakes up, she's like, you know, kind of feel like having a beer.
Hey, you want a beer?
Smoking some weed? Or do you maybe having some premarital sex?
Or we can have premarital sex.
it might work. It might work. Okay, shout out, Alan. Go
ahead. I'd like to give a shout out to Dr. Randolph's office.
Randolph.
I just started my psychotherapy session, so.
Oh, I hate this.
Psychotherapy.
He does not need psychotherapy. And
you guys put him next to me, the psycho over here. He's like, I need psychotherapy.
He doesn't need it. You know how they all
want a beer? Or do you want to smoke some pot?
That's what you should do.
Or we can have premarital sex.
Okay, Dr. Randolph, what else?
Forget about the therapy.
My hand is as big as your face. You better stop. Okay, so shout out. Anybody else?
Whitney just came back from Utah.
Yay, Utah!
And she came back on Friday the 13th? October Friday the 13th?
Like a couple weeks ago.
Well, then she didn't just come
just
back.
Just come back. Well, I give a shout out to Whitney because she gave me a special gift from Utah.
Hey, cool.
Yay, Utah! What did you get?
I'm not telling you.
The Salt Lake is dry. Mormon country.
What did you get?
Not telling you. You can ask your girlfriend. Oh, hey, Tone, you got a special shout out?
Not right now, Alan.
Yeah, don't.
Stop.
He's such a moron. Okay, Tones, shout out.
I'd like to give a shout out to Eliza Dushku.
Dushku. You know what? I'm going to make some pierogies and some Dushku.
Dushku.
Yeah. I'm going to invite you over.
Some pierogi.
I want you to eat my hot Dushku.
I just made a hot
douche
in the toilet.
Have you ever tried this spicy douche?
Hey, you want a beer?
Okay.
Or do you want to smoke some pot?
Do you want to have some premarital douche?
Premarital douche. Okay, Liza douche.
Shout out to the darkening.
Yay. Yes.
Guys. Shout out to all you guys.
Shout out to all of us.
And yeah, you're going to have a good time, man. It's Halloween.
Halloween. Halloween. Halloween. Halloween. Sorry.
All right.
I want to give a special shout out to UHMC because you guys are awesome for hosting the Volume 2 of Maui Comic Con. Shout out to all the. Do it again. Do it again. shout out Maui Monstar. Mr. Cinema Junkie, we still got love for you, brother.
Yeah, man.
Derek.
Thanks for holding it down.
And, of course, shout out Marky Mark.
What's up, Mark? We miss you.
And Maui Mark. All the Marks in the house, you know what I'm saying? And that's about it.
All the Jasons and Joshes out there.
Joshes. Jake and Josh. Shout out to, of course, my FNF Familia. And you guys watching and listening, of course. That's about it. We do this with love and harmony, ladies and gentlemen. Peace, Shaka, dig Johanna Bada. We out.
We're out. And you have been listening to Friday Night Frights.
Go cook your girlfriend some dinner tonight.
88.5 FM, the voice of Maui, broadcasting out of Otaku, Maui Community. Eat tempura ham.
Exclusive enough to link the murderer of Celia Shepherd to other murders in the Vallejo area in the past year.
Anywhere in the Bay Area or anywhere, he should go to the nearest law enforcement agency and turn himself in. And we will try to do whatever we can to help this man.
Early last Saturday evening, Celia Shepherd and Brian Hartnell, both in their early 20s, were sitting on this knoll of land overlooking part of Lake Berryessa. They thought they were alone, but there was a third man on this knoll, a man who wore a medieval-style executioner's hood, carried a knife and gun, and intended to use them.
He is a pathological psycho killer. There's no doubt about it.
Is there any doubt in your mind that there is or is not any connection between Vallejo and Berryessa?
We're sifting out now. I wouldn't say that there is any connection, yet I wouldn't want to tell you that there isn't at this time. We have some pretty good physical evidence that we're working on now. Mm-hmm. And of course, we're going to get together with the Vallejo authorities. We've been in contact with them since the incident, and we definitely will pool our resources.
Tied him up, and then he still didn't take the money. And the kid said, the money's in my pocket. He said, I don't want the money. All I want to do is kill you. Yeah, when I arrived on the scene at Saturday night around 7:13, well, found this young girl in on the shoreline here, all stabbed in several places. And her boyfriend, male companion, had came to from, he had been stabbed, and he had taken off for help. Mm-hmm. And the other patrolman came in, which is Dennis Land. He found him some 100 yards.